Hi, welcome to the Autumnberry Inn. You must be freezing. Here, let me grab your blanket. Oh, goodness, it's so cold outside right now. Yeah, unfortunately, I gave away my last good furs to another customer. Please warm up by the fire. Whew, it is a chilly one tonight. Can I get you something to drink? We have wine, we have water and ale, mead, milk. Okay, of course. Must have traveled far. Yeah. Let's see, the closest town, Rainfort. Yeah, that's quite a whiles away. Gershning, wow, that is quite far. Yes, please get warm. Fruit too, maybe? Yeah. Okay, perfect. I have a variety here of blueberries. Yes. Blueberries and these beautiful winter crisp apples. Yeah. And yes, all of our fruit comes from the garden. So, on Sundays, I go to the market and get some fruit from Mr. Bimble. He has the best fruit ever. So whenever we're running low on blueberries or apples or anything like that, if you are free on Sunday, you should definitely go check out his stand. Yeah. So, okay, blueberries. And I also have some cheese too. You can use it to spread on your bread if you would like. Yes, all of that. Okay, great. Great. Thank you. extra little pack of snacks. So, don't mind me. I have so many of these to fold. A whole horde of ogres came in earlier. They were demanding food, which of course we're happy to serve them. But they destroyed all of the napkins. Quite a marvel watching them eat. I know that sounds silly, but they just eat everything, including our napkins. So I had to go into our storage and find a whole bunch of new ones, but they're all wrinkled. Yeah. Anyway, so you've traveled quite a far ways. Are you planning on staying here for a while? Great. That'll be really nice. Maybe I'll see your face around here more. Yeah. So, are you traveling by yourself? Oh, cool. What kind of business do you do? Oh, wonderful. Well, we are in need of an app. So, perhaps I could commission some napkins to be made. That's wonderful. How long have you been doing that for? I see. Did you make your clothes? Because they're gorgeous. You're very skilled. Wow. That's amazing. Well, if you do stick around down, we could definitely use another handy worker making beautiful, beautiful clothes. Yeah. So you do also. Wow. I never have really gone on an adventure myself. Unless you count going out into you're here on business, but also adventure. Very interesting. Well, there is someone I know that you might be able to talk to about where to go next for your adventure. Now, I met her when I was just a little girl, and I can't remember exactly what I was going for. Maybe I was chasing after pixies or trying to find the little fablings that kept on raiding our kitchen. But I wandered outside into the forest late at night and I got completely lost. And the forest out here is very dense, which I'm sure you're aware of since you had to go through that. But across a little hut, and the most delicious baked goods. The smell of them just came wafting in my face, and I couldn't help myself but go over to the little hut, and inside was the nicest girl named Vine. At least that's what I called her, because she was of nature. She had beautiful plants everywhere, and I just thought Vine was like a nice name. She didn't mind though. And she would send me off on the most fun adventures, collecting mushrooms and catching butterflies and getting their essence and then releasing them, things like that. But I have a sense that she also knows more about outside of things only a child could do. So, if you're looking for an adventure, perhaps you should try to get lost in the woods and come across Vine. Sometimes I can just go outside at night and and we'll sit and have a nice chat, and she'll tell me all about the little creatures that visited her little hut that day. There are just so many of them. Yes. Yeah. Today hasn't been too busy here in the inn. Although, there are some suspicious things going on. For example, my nutmeg has gone completely missing. I'm not sure what might have taken it, but I suspect that it's the little fablings. The fablings. Yes, I believe that they're native here, because most travelers haven't heard of them or seen them before. But they're about the size of your palm, and they're like a peachy pink color. They're adorable, and they look like little tiny gnomes with long white beards. Now, they're very, very sneaky, and they have adorned in their beards little beads and trinkets, I think, that they find and steal from people at the marketplace. Well, apparently, if you give them a smile and a wave, they get so bashful and embarrassed that they run away. Who knows if they come back or not to steal your stuff? I'm sure they do. But the smallest act of kindness can go a long way. Most people think of them as pests, and rightfully so. The little buggers. I'm certain of it that they're the ones stealing my nutmeg. Who knows what they're doing with that? I would like to imagine that they go back to their little homes and make the tiniest little loaves of bread using my spices. Yes, you've noticed the little table for them. Yes, I have been leaving out food for them. And I've left them a little book too, just in case they want to, I don't know, write things down, keep their own little journal. They've ruffled through the pages, that's for sure. And every morning, whenever I leave something out, it's always gone. How was your wine? Good. Okay. You would like another glass? Of course. Feeling a little more warm. Good. I'm sure the wine is helping. So, how many nights are you planning on staying here at the inn? Okay, great. Yes, we definitely have availability right now. Been a little bit slower than usual. That's okay. Since it's been so cold, I think there haven't been as many travelers lately. Everyone's staying inside their homes trying to keep warm. So we have a number of rooms that you can choose from. Most of them are views of the lake. The beautiful, beautiful lake outside. I know it's dark, but there's a lake right behind the inn that stretches on for as long as you can see. And of course, the forest surrounds it. That's the majority of where our rooms overlook. Some people say that they've seen the most interesting things out in the lake. One person said that they saw a lizard creature. Yeah. Like a really big one, the size of a ship. Just floating out on the lake. And when they tried to bring their friends over to look at it too, it was gone. Who knows? He was so flustered when he told me about it. None of his friends believed him. I could tell, though, there was honesty in his eyes. So, tell me more about the adventure that you're going. Myself, I'm definitely not a magic user. So I'm sorry, I can't really help you out in that area. But I do believe that vine that I told you about, I believe she could help you with that. Yeah. Now, I have met her out in the forest just out back here. Just walking to the edge of the forest and calling out her name. But I can tell you where her hut is, too. Yeah, okay, sure. So, if you just go straight out of this, of the inn, and keep on walking north for about 5 minutes, you're sure to run right into it. It seems like it's exactly where our front door is, just a little bit further out. Yeah. And if you get lost, I'm sure that she would be more than happy to come to your aid if you just start calling out her name. And if you start saying fine, she'll know that I sent you to her. I have asked her, yes. She refuses to tell me. She says that Vine is a name that suits her better. I love the nighttime here too. It's peaceful. And just sit by the fire, listen to a crackle. Sometimes too. Really close, you might hear the little chittering of the pixies. Yes, they sound like little tiny muttering people just yelling at each other. They're quite talkative. Once you hear them, it's sometimes hard to not hear them anymore. They chitter at each other back and forth. Until sunrise. Vine was telling me about that. She's the one that told me to listen really carefully. And sometimes, if you look really closely, the fireflies that you see glowing are actually little pixie wings. To avoid predators, or perhaps to avoid getting captured by greedy little humans. Businesses too, but there is the upper class, the royalty that runs part of this land also. So they ask for a small share of our profits. Yeah. In the morning, you'll meet some of the guests here that are staying, and boy, some of them were gossiping all night long last night. They were just gossiping about the royalty. I think that it's quite trivial gossip, but it's still juicy nonetheless. Especially when it comes to the royalty. A lord named Lord Ventremere and Lady Byriel. And apparently the latest news is that they recently broke up. Lady Byriel, she seemed to be very upset about this. And there was much anticipated banquet they were supposed to go to together. So Lord Ventremere, he showed up on the arm of another woman. Another lady, I didn't catch her name. But apparently at the banquet, when Lord Ventremere stood up, his pants fell down. And I can't imagine the embarrassment he must have felt. But the rumor Lady Byriel hired someone to magically pounce him to embarrass him for breaking up with her and showing up with another woman. Who knows? It's all speculation at this point, but I did hear some guards over talking, and they said that there's an ongoing investigation behind this crime. So it's obviously something that is taken very seriously out at the palace. Let's see. Is the blanket warm enough for you? Sometimes it can just get so drafty in here too, if it's cold outside. Yes. So, do you have any plans for tomorrow? Oh, yes. Actually, there is a witch here in town. Yeah, her name's Delphine. She is very sweet. She would definitely for like a potion or protection, definitely for your travels, especially if you plan to go further east. Yeah, actually, since we're talking about Delphine and if you might visit her, would you be okay if I send something with you? course, you don't need to take it. I can always make the trip myself. But thank you so much. Thank you. It's actually this little satchel. Satchel, yeah, and she's been asking about around town for some lavender, and I told her that I actually just made a trip to the Oakland fields just outside of town and got her some lavender, and so I've been meaning to make my way down there, but sometimes I can't get away from the inn. Be amazing if you could give this to her and send her my love. She's a very sweet lady. Yes, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Now, oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Do you have any potion or medicine to help with that? I'm sure you got it on the way here. With how cold it is outside. Well, I don't have any, like, remedies necessarily that will cure you, but I do have some tea that I can give you and that you can brew whenever you're feeling a little bit stuffy. It'll just make you feel so much better. Yeah. Here, let me grab it for you here. Let's see. So I think I have some time here that I'm not sure. I'm not going to really be the kind of spot that I'm looking for for this. Okay, then I also have some glow, which is really nice, but it's my own personal blend of chamomile and some other herbs that I go picking on the weekends. So if you brew half of this with some hot water and let it boil for 10 minutes, you'll have the most perfect tea. It always helps me whenever I feel like I have a head cold. Yeah, this is my favorite. Soothing. Yeah. Oh yeah. That's a good batch right there. There you go. Yeah. I see you finished your wine. Did you like it? Oh, great to hear. Yes, it's actually from Victor down the street. Victor's Vine. What a character that guy is. Sometimes he'll stop in here just for a quick snack and to catch up. He's very elderly. And ever since I was little, I remember him being older too. I don't know how old he is. But he is a little stout dwarf. And he sure knows his wine. And He was always so kind to me. Never rude, he could have yelled at me. But he also had a bunny rabbit named Theodore that would be hopping around the vineyards and also in his garden. So me and Theodore would go hop around, and I would take Theodore and go to Victor's front garden and pretend that we were having tea together. Me and Theodore. Anyway, are you planning on going to Delphine's tomorrow? I'm sure she'll have something that'll cure your cold right away. Yeah. And also offer you.